welcome to my Jet Force Gemini Epilogue episode. I thought I would mention a few other things that I actually did say in the original playthrough, however, they didn't make the final YouTube cut. And in fact, about 62% of all of the raw footage got cut completely. I'm actually really happy with the way that the series did turn out. I feel like it's considerably better than, well, especially better than my previous works. But yeah, that's kind of the fun thing, is being able to constantly improve a little bit at a time. So the first thing I would like to mention is actually the individual title screens. We saw many different title screens as we played through the game. In fact, when you first start, you have Juno running down the corridor, and as you play far enough in the game with Juno to unlock Vila, then the title screen suddenly switches to Juno and Vila running down the corridor. However, in the playthrough of mine, we continued playing as Juno and unlocked the politically correct renamed by me robot thing. We then unlock actually a third title screen of Juno, Vila, and Robot Thing running down the corridor. However, once you play far enough with Vila, you then unlock Lupus, and so you have all four of them running down the corridor. And alas, when you beat Mizar the first time, you get the armor upgrades, and so you have the entire team with a now fifth title screen where they are running down the corridor with their upgraded armor. However, once you beat the game in its entirety, you have the victory march, which is them calm, cool, collectedly watching, as we saw at the end of the series there. None of that can actually be sequence break. We have to unlock Vila with Juno, and we have to unlock Lupus with Vila. However, interestingly enough, you could, technically speaking, the moment you unlock Vila with Juno, play as Vila and unlock Lupus. So the question actually remains, is there a title screen that features Juno, Vila, and Lupus where Juno has not yet unlocked Robot Thing? I'm actually not sure. This is saved cart-wide though, so if I, you know, do anything, it's always going to have the victory title screen as of now, unless I completely erase the save in its entirety, at which point I can start over. But I'm honestly very curious is if the Robot Thing can just be a sprite that's added, or actually it's 3D, so the 3D model that's simply added whether or not you collect it. But I'm curious, to those inspired viewers on the internet, I mean, feel free to experiment. And wasn't it so hilarious watching me perform absolutely deplorably bad on the SS Anubis Robot Thing mission, trying to get those stupid earplugs? In all fairness, here is a screenshot I would like to share of my absolute best performance. Notice the time, as well as I did in fact collect all 8 circuit boards and destroy all 4 items. So I truly firmly believe that you had to complete not only the primary objectives but the secondary objectives as well, and finish in under a minute or whatever the gold medal time was in order to get the earplugs, because why look, I actually did do that. So, didn't do it. It didn't happen in the 2021 run, but honestly, it kind of turned out to be a hilarious realization when I actually did win the earplugs completely unknowingly and unexpectedly. Another thing that unfortunately didn't make the YouTube cut, because honestly, it didn't fit anywhere, was the second cheat. I actually did obtain 200 heads with Juno, and so therefore it unlocked our second cheat, which in the case of this game is in fact Jet Force Kids. Now, notice what model was on the screen. Bam! And then notice instantaneously we have this much chibi, smaller child version of Juno. So notice it actually does have the armor expansion pack, and let me go ahead and pop over to Vila. Alright, so notice also Vila also has a very short chibi style child model. This cheat only affects Vila or Juno. So there's an actually interesting story behind this cheat. This was not something that Rareware decided, oh, this would be cute to have, like, you know, large-headed childlike models that they threw in at the end of the game as a cheat. Actually, as the game was progressing, originally Juno and Vila were extremely young, childlike characters like this. However, as the story goes, Rareware had whatever focus group that they did, and they just didn't quite get the reception that they wanted. People, I guess, didn't connect. They weren't, you know, they didn't quite understand, I guess, the British humor side of this sort of game. And so, really, what is this game rated? It's rated T. And so, very smartly, I guess they thought, well, maybe we should make the characters Juno and Vila target the teen audience. And so they made them really essentially like teenage sort of models, maybe even young adult, late teens. And honestly, that was a great decision because you can look at that and see, oh, this is, you know, a strong teen woman, a strong teen man going around with big guns, blowing up bugs and ants and all sorts of insects. And of course, that is going to appeal to a teenage sort of age group and therefore be a bigger, a better commercial sale than had they stuck with this. So in any event, they already have the models, right? So it's still in the game by virtue of this 200 head collected cheat. Another hilarious thing that was a complete mistake on my part was the fact that when I designed this overlay, there was a 2.0 version. In fact, it's staring you right in the face right now. In fact, notice right by my Wyoming cowboy is Robot Thing. And so actually what I was going to originally do is when Juno unlocked Robot Thing, it would have shifted to a different overlay and then it would have had him on the rest of the game. And honestly, it wasn't until I got done with the entire series, right, exported every single video, watched every single Final Cut video from beginning to end, made any corrections and fixes if needed, and I'm like, oh shoot, my Robot Thing overlay. So unfortunately, it was way too late to go back and fix that, but as you can see now, I do have it as one final hurrah. This was what it was supposed to be from Tafret onward. I had so much fun playing through this game, and it actually occurred 7 months ago from the time that I actually was able to play this, make the recordings, to finishing my video series here. And it's hard to put into words, honestly. You can't rate the game a 10, right? Because that's technically speaking illegal, because nothing is perfect. But you know, like that, blowing up bugs, it never gets old. And I mean, look at all this beautiful rainbow colored blood. So in closing, thank you all so much for watching. This game was so much fun. This game was so fun to play. It was so fun to edit. And it's so much fun to even do an epilogue episode for. And until we meet again, this is Great Games Before Your Time, signing off. We can come back here. What happens if we fall off the edge, though? Oh, you can! There you have it. We had to know for science.